Hello my friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to the second round of sharing my picture settings with you. And this time we're talking about the service menu. And unfortunately I have to bring it up here again. I did it in our last video as well, but keep in mind, all those settings what I'm going to share with you are my settings for my TV, okay? LG CX 65 inch, okay? Even you have the same panel, the same TV, you will not have the same outcome, okay? But of course, you can try my settings. There is nothing wrong with the settings because you can't harm anything. But please be careful what you change in the service menu, okay? We are talking or we are doing some changes in the service menu today, and we need to be very careful what we're doing, but I will show you, of course, step by step what to change. Okay, and here we are with my settings for the service menu. And before we start, have a look here on the original values and do me a favor and put in the comment section what you have on your LG CX 65 inch or maybe 55 inch, but put also in what panel type you have, because I really like to know if you end up with the same values here, 192, 167, 121 in warm. Okay, so the green, the cut values are always 64 in all the color temperature settings in the service menu, but I like to know if you have similar settings or different one, because I like to know if LG is doing something like a pre-calibration before they're sending out the TVs. Because if you have a different value and you have a LG CX 65 inch, that means actually LG is pre-calibrating their TVs in the factory. If we end up with the same settings on all the TV, that means LG is just updating the TVs with the same software. But anyway, that's just for this. So, what I have to say also, and there's no script, so that's why it's a little bit, I hope I'm not forgetting anything. So first of all this yellow stuff is mandatory in my opinion, or let's say like this, mandatory to get the same result what I have on my TV, okay? So of course, feel free to change whatever you want with all that light, but don't complain later on if you're not ending up with a good picture. So this is, in my opinion, mandatory to have a great picture. Even you're using those values and you not have the same outcome, with those settings you should have at least a very nice picture out of the box, okay? So I will put this up later on in the end, so you can copy and paste this as you like. So now we have a look here. So we have service menu calibrated values, and you can see they are complete different values. And also I used or I changed the cut values as well this time, and I ended up with a very nice result, and I'm really happy about this. So keep in mind, I have two different settings for SDR, and the other setting is for HDR and Dolby Vision. So HDR and Dolby Vision is exactly the same. So how I did my testing. So I did my testing with HCFR, not with Karman, because there are too many, I don't like Karman, because every time when I'm opening Karman, it will change some on the picture settings, or it will gray something out or whatever. I just don't like it anymore, okay? I'm using HCFR, because what I learned is I compared HCFR in manual calibration with Karman, and I ended up with the same result, okay? So there's no difference, because at the end it's the same meter and the software is doing a great job. HCFR is doing a great job. Very sorry, I'm very sad that it's actually not, there's no one working on the software anymore. It's very old software, but it's still very good in my opinion. So we're using SDR and So I'm using different values for SDR and a different value for HDR and Dolby Vision. Why? Because there is a difference. And I explained this already in my other video, in my first video. I measured SDR on with HCFR and automatic pattern control or whatever. So the pattern was manual, now automatically generated by HCFR. For HDR, I used actually my Xbox and the Spears and Munzel DVD or Blu-ray DVD. So unfortunately, I can't measure the Dolby Vision. I would be able to do this with Karma, but again, I don't want to. Back then, when I did my testing in terms of HDR and Dolby Vision, I did not found any difference whatsoever in terms of the values, because at the least we need to consider something. When you change those settings here in warm in the service menu, and I will show it is now, we're pressing the adjustment button and then 0413, and we go straight to white balance. Okay, so, and we turn this off here. So we have here color temperature, cool, medium and warm. So what I'm always doing is I'm using cool for SDR and warm for HDR. So, and what I learned is there is really a difference, as you can see in the values already. And can you see that the picture is slightly changing now? So this is just because now this is a SDR picture and warm is actually the settings for HDR. I did my comparison back then with HDR, Dolby Vision and whatsoever. There is no difference between HDR and the same settings and Dolby Vision and the same setting. It was white, was white. It was the same value, okay? Full stop. So that's what I found. So maybe there is a difference, but I did not find anything back then. So, but what I found is a difference between SDR and HDR / Dolby Vision. There is a difference. And this is most likely because we have a different behavior from the panel, of course. In SDR, we have less brightness, much less brightness over, compared to HDR. HDR, of course, 700 candela, something around that. In SDR, around 200 candela. The behavior from the panel, of course, is different. That's why I ended up to have different values here as well. But at the end, and I will show you my results, of course, in a second as well, I love my result. I can't complain at all. So, what I have done here, again, cool is my SDR setting, which I put in SDR cool and SDR cool. So what I mean with a service menu, that's the name in the service menu, cool. And here it's warm. And here in the picture option, and I will show you this also in a second, you have to choose cool and then warm too, okay? But let me show you. So all what I've done is we're not touching red. I just changed green, blue, and here then the cut values. I also tried not to go below 64. I'm not quite sure if this approach is correct. Maybe someone else like Ninjian can also maybe confirm this. I tried not to go below 64. I tried to go ahead or increase more than 64. So not quite sure if this behavior or the approach is actually not behavior, approach is right, but I couldn't find any problem with this one. Okay, so this is what I've ended up for cool, and of course this is for the warm for HDR. This is what I ended up. So, and also you can see even on the lower end there's a little bit of a different funny part is actually when you compare this in a 30% gray pattern and you switch between cool and warm, and maybe I can actually show you this. We have just 80 IRE, unfortunately. But can you see this? You have a difference here. When I'm doing this now in an SDR picture with 30% IRE, I can't show you this because as soon as I'm going over here, it's 80 back, then there's a big, big difference. But the fun part is again, when you have now SDR and HDR picture and you compare those exact pictures with the right settings, it's absolutely identical. So again, HDR and SDR, different behavior. That's what I learned. So again, using cool for SDR and warm for HDR. So let's jump out here with exit and let me show you what I mean with the cool and whatever. So just imagine this is whatever picture mode you like to use, because that's why I like the service menu calibration. You change this in the service menu once and then across the whole TV, every input, every single input, it's the same, full stop, okay? And all what we need to do is white balance. And this time, make sure, do this. Go here and press reset, okay? Press reset, make sure there's nothing what can actually add on the calibration whatsoever. Press reset, make sure everything is set to the right value here, of course. Go to advanced controls and then, see, this is what I don't understand. Why is this changing to white? This is not right. Anyway, white balance, and depends on if you're now using at this very moment the SDR picture mode or HDR or Dolby Vision picture mode, change it accordingly. Cool for SDR, doesn't matter if it's expert bright or expert dark or filmmaker mode or gaming SDR, it doesn't matter at all. As soon as it's SDR, it's cool, okay? As soon as you're using HDR, HDR gaming, Dolby Vision, Netflix or whatsoever, change it to warm too, okay? Do this. And then you have a really nice picture. So I'm going to change this back to cool because at the moment I'm using my service menu settings and this is a SDR picture. And now let's talk about, let's talk about my results. So it was a long day already, so apologize for my unscripted videos here. But anyway, so let's talk about results. Where are we here? HDR warm 2 for service menu. And this is what we're ending up. So that's the result. And I'm not 100% happy. But the problem is every time when and also we need to consider this. Every time when you do a measurement and then let's say you measure or you verify your measurement the next day, you end up with a different result. And this is what happened here. And I was just too lazy to correct it actually. But I'm still happy because I'm quite sure today with just 24 degrees in the room, it is different as well. You know what I mean? So this is also what we need to consider. Every time when you measure something and even you put the meter on the exact same spot, you will end up with a different result because the panel has a different temperature, the panel is aging, the environment temperature is different and that's affecting the sensor from the calorimeter and so on and so on. So that's why you're not ending up with always the same. So what I have to say here is that I'm very happy with the result here in the top end, but not very happy in the lower end. So, but it was very hard actually because to correct this one, because as soon I went down one tick with red, everything was too bluish, you know what I mean? So this was really the best what I can do. And I'm not happy about 2.1, not at all. I'm happy about 0.9 because we're talking about a 2-point calibration. Nothing else, not a 22, not a 10-point. 2-point calibration. And all what I'm doing is always using 30 and 70 IOE to do my 2-point calibration. And that's the result. And I really can say it's not bad, of course. Of course, we can do it better with a 22-point calibration, but then we would use probably 5 hours instead of two minutes or whatever it took. So we had this HDR warm 2, and where is my SDR cool? So this is SDR cool and it looks a little bit different, and actually the result is a little bit better compared to HDR, but still HDR is great. But can you see here 0.5 in the 5 and we had 2 point something in HDR, so you can see complete different behavior from SDR, and that's why I'm using cool and warm to separate those picture modes, okay? So this is what you're ending up here. Very, very nice. And also keep in mind, I haven't touched color correction with the service menu at all. Not at all. Because first of all, in HDR, I don't think there's a point to do it in manual calibration because the panel is not capable of showing you the full REC 2020 spectrum or color volume or whatsoever. So you will just end up with not a good result, okay? So even in automatic mode, if we're talking about Karman, the result is not that good, okay? Not that good. It is a little bit better than in if you leave it, but still I was not impressed, to be very honest. I'm waiting for TVs actually where we can really have the full potential, or we can see the full REC 2020, but I really think this will take a couple of years, you know, not with OLED, probably maybe with a different technology, but I don't think that OLED is capable of showing us this, yeah, the colorful volume and the brightness especially, okay? So again, did I miss anything? Because I haven't, there's no script at all, you know what I mean? I think I actually touched all the points. I'm still quite happy with the service menu calibration, and I would actually recommend this. If you're not, if you don't fear to use the service menu, go ahead and do this, because then you have all the settings, those settings for the whole TV, and you don't need to do it. And even you do a factory reset or whatever on your TV, those values are still the same. So what I found, so they are not going to back to this settings, because, or maybe it was, at least it was a my TV like this, okay? So I really like the service menu calibration because it's much easier, okay? But it's completely up to you. You will end up with the same result if you do it with the picture mode, with the standard remote control. There is no difference in the outcome from the picture at the end, okay? So not much of a difference, okay? So I would say that's enough for this video. I hope I did not forget anything. And I will bring it up here as well. I will do this soon, okay? I think that's it. Okay, so try the settings. Don't be afraid to try the settings, because you can't mix up. You can't harm your TV. But make sure when you change something in your service menu, make sure pencil down your settings, because then you can change it later on back. And again, put in the comment section what values you have here, because I'm really interested in this if we have different settings, okay? So that's for this video, and now I will actually going to play this, okay? What is this? I don't know. Anyway, there's so much stuff in here. Anyway, so thank you very much for watching me. I see you guys next time. Bye.